military history that this is in fact a higher level of restoration. And they went along with it, and it wasn't too much more talking to convince them to let us demonstrate the vehicles periodically too. In Minnesota, we do have another armor museum, but everything is always standing display. You see something rolling, rather than just in a textbook or only a picture. It's going to be an infantry. This is an 8-inch self-propelled howitzer. You'll see some of the ammunition rounds on display out in the outer area here. Not counting the rail guns and the piecemeal guns that they dry in two or three sections. This is one of the largest artillery pieces the U.S. Army had in use for quite some period of time. One of the advantages to a self-propelled howitzer, of course, is you can shoot and scoop. So by the time the enemy figures out where you are, you're gone. This 8-inch gun is capable of throwing projectiles up to 20, 30 miles, some of them with rocket assist, some of them with tactical nuclear warheads. This particular gun barrel is now in a 6-foot transportation mode, which means the barrel would extend forward another 6 feet in operation. It had an automatic hydraulic motor in the back, not a hydraulic motor in the back, and a rather large recoil stage, as you can see. We used this vehicle yesterday to end the analog television era, and it drove over a TV set on behalf of the promotion that Fox News was giving us for today. Beautiful M110, we have two of these. They're still waiting to be restored, but we still are doing what we can to keep them operational and viewable for our visitors. It's a very heavy gun, by the way. And the muzzle brake on the end, but I just told him weighs around 700 pounds in this vicinity. We get a good view of the recoil state. The howitzer was back in the space, so when it fired off its shell, it was just a fabric case rather than a metal one. It was like a maple product, and a heck of a recoil. That vehicle is an M106. Most of us would recognize it as M113, which also has the aluminum armor of the Vietnam period. A really beautiful restoration job that is on display often in the 88 compound area over by the village. It also was designed to be efficient, driving along pretty fast, propelling through the water. The piece of wood in the front is actually a surf shield, was put down, was folded down at an angle. You didn't get a bow wave going over and watching the driver down into the vehicle.